It is an incredible time to be alive. General Michael Flynn, multi-star general, former head of Defense Intelligence Agency. That's Pentagon Intelligence. One of the most important intelligence agencies of the 16. Went public and said, we were ordered to create Al-Qaeda and ISIS and let them take over Syria. It was a conscious plan and we don't like it. We don't stand with it. And I told you at the time, there is absolute war in the Pentagon between the State Department and a faction of the CIA on one side and factions of the CIA, Defense Intelligence, the U.S. Army on the other side. And I've been told this by, let's just say, active duty people. This is extremely dangerous. And we've talked about it hundreds of times here the last few years. You saw the military, including officers, holding up signs saying, I won't be Al-Qaeda's Air Force in Syria 2.5, 3 years ago. Rand Paul coming out saying we shouldn't be Al-Qaeda's Air Force. Many of the officers hold up the signs, Infowars.com. We had Tosh Plumlee retire as a CIA contractor to go public here and say from NATO and from military, confirming shipping high-impact TOW missiles, Stinger missiles, and others directly to Syrian rebels via Turkey. And now, Volume 38, Number 1, January 7th, 2016, just came out this morning. It is a lengthy Cy Hersh report, 14 pages long, that we will do a special report on the news about tonight and more in the third hour. It is unbelievable. This is a two-time Pulitzer Prize winner. This is a man given CIA clearance to investigate. He is a listener. He's emailed back and forth with us, but never comes on the show. Now is the time. He has confirmed everything in triplicate, that there is a war between senior staff and different agencies. And I don't want to say the Navy and the Army, but because the whole Navy's not bad, but the Navy has been siding basically with the globalist more than the Army. Because there is a cult of George Washington in the Army, and it's really hard to break it because they've done a lot of corrupt, bad stuff, but this is coming down to killing the country right now. And I know Jesse Ventura is a Navy man. I'm not bashing the Navy. We're going to go to him with big breaking news from his trip to Russia. But that is now all in here, that they're funding Al-Qaeda, Al-Nusra, ISIS in Turkey, sending them in with weapons. Then the other group of generals actually is in contact with Assad. This is in the New Yorker magazine, folks. Cy Hersh, not Alex Jones now. Of course, we told you 2 years ago, 3 years ago. But this is confirmed. They then directly give Assad the intel on how to beat him. And that's why Colonel Schaefer came on a few months ago and said, we are now working with the Russians openly. We are going to destroy ISIS and Al-Qaeda. And I said, and that was from congressional secret meetings he was at. He put out the info here. He's authorized to do that. You understand? Authorized by the government to come on my show and tell you that. There is a full-on war close to Operation Valkyrie going on right now, where our own government doesn't want to be part of this, that is, sections of this incredible evil. And when the Navy SEALs didn't go along with the fake Bin Laden story, they just blew up their helicopter, didn't they? And I've talked to some of those families and people in person. They've been on the show years after I told you I met with them in person. Other families. But do you understand, folks, there is a full-on war right now for this country, and it's dangerous. Now, Jesse Ventura went to Russia to be part of a big press event. He was at an event Putin was at, had a chance to talk to him briefly. Very interesting. But the big thing, Jesse, you've never heard him this excited in a while, was about the parallels between how Russia is changing and how America is changing. And I asked him to tell me more, and he said, well, you know, when I'm coming on the show, I'll just tell you then. That was last Friday. So he joins us now. He's got Off the Grid TV show. It's very popular and aired on different TV networks and things around the world, not just here in the United States. The story's up on Infowars.com. President Vladimir Putin personally thanked Jesse Ventura during Moscow visit. And I literally, during the three-minute break, was given this article and scanned over it. Richard had already read it and was getting ready to highlight it for me, but I checked the parts he talked about. I already knew all this, but here's Cy Hersh admitting open war going on in the government. What do you think when they have top generals coming out saying this and top analysts saying we've been ordered to protect Al-Qaeda and ISIS? And yes, who'd you hear talk about this 3 years ago? Jesse Ventura. myself and others, we've known what's going on, but now it's so out in the open, it's so dangerous, it makes my head spin. And yes, you've got neocons and you've got the Obama people on one side, and then you've got the rest of the military and more libertarian conservatives on the other. Now, joining us is Jesse Ventura for the balance of the hour. Governor, thank you so much for coming on. I just broke all this here on air. Cy Hersh just broke it this morning. We've discussed this over and over again. When you were on just a few months ago, we discussed this exact topic. So it's not breaking for us, but how incredible is this to have the most respected reporter in the world, in my view, I don't think that's disputed, Seymour Hersh, coming out and confirming in a 14-page report this incredible information. It's military to military, Seymour Hersh on U.S. intelligence sharing in the Syrian war. Headline should be Civil War Inside the Federal Government Over Backing of Al-Qaeda. Jesse Ventura.
Well, first of all, Alex, that's stunning news. It's news to me. I knew nothing about it. I was working out this morning, and that's the first I've heard of it. It's not surprising. I will tell you this. Do you want to know why the Navy gets their pick? Because we've beaten Army 14 years in a row. So that's how they determine who's on top, whoever wins the Army-Navy game. And Navy's won 14 years in a row, so that's how come Navy gets priority. Anyway, humor aside, the situation you got now is because it all goes back to why are we there in the first place when you truly look at it. You know, Alex, you and I have beefed over immigration and all that stuff, but here's where I stand now. I stand for this, and I stand with Major General Smedley Butler, the Marine who won 2 Congressional Medals of Honor. Our military shouldn't go over 500 miles from our own shore, so let's bring them home. Let's secure our borders with the U.S. military, both southern and northern borders, because we don't want to discriminate. And let's end all immigration to the United States, take down the Statue of Liberty, say it doesn't apply anymore, because if you end just immigration to certain people, then you're discriminating. You either have, in the words of immigration, it has to be all or none.
No, I get there's two sides to it, and I want to get into that later, because there's so much happening currently, but undoubtedly, how do you bring in people from Syria, a lot of them that invaded, not even vet them, and then let them attack? I mean, obviously, citizens get screened coming in. You get screened. I mean, a lot of these immigrants don't even get screened is the issue, Jesse, is the unfairness.
Well, the unfairness is, too, it's not the immigrants. If you
I
look
agree.
At the France, wait, if you look at the France attack, those were Belgian citizens. Those weren't immigration. Those weren't people. They weren't refugees.
Some
let
of them
put it that
were out of Greece, but you're right, somewhere in Europe. But let's expand on this before we get off into immigration. How big a deal is it? Is that it's? I mean, you were in some big panels with former CIA people, you name it. You're here to talk about your amazing experience in Russia, but we know the West has been funding and Turkey's been funding and buying the oil. That's all come out. Our own military is saying they don't want to go along with this. I mean, that's a pretty big deal.
Alex, this is all part of the culture of America today. We are a war culture. We must. Why do you think they tried to trump up the Cold War with the Russians again? Because we have to be at war all the time to support the military-industrial complex and all the money makers. You got to remember something. Anytime you go to war, there are war profiteers. There are people that make huge money off the war. No war is away from that. World War II, Korea, Vietnam. You name the war, and there are war profiteers, people who profit from those wars. So it's in their best interest to stay at war. It's in the best interest, they believe, of the United States to have a common enemy so that we're at war all the time. And when they couldn't find one, they came in with the war on drugs, which has proved to be a war against their very own citizens.
You're absolutely right.
Of the United States of America.
Well, let's... Absolutely. Let's start getting into Russia, because that's really the reason we're here. It's so important, and it ties into this. I mean, the very same people trying to overthrow Syria are trying to overthrow Ukraine and then spending it that Russia did all this when George Soros and Brzezinski and others admit the State Department spent $5 billion engineering the overthrow of the elected government. That segues to your trip to Russia that was very interesting.
Yeah, no, I got to go. They carry off the grid is carried by RT America, Russian Television America, on Friday nights. And they won't have me on RTV. So isn't it ironic that a former governor has to go get his show on Russian television.
Well, so does Larry King.
Yeah, so does Larry King. That's right. But no, RT is a tremendous station. I love the station. And they offered my wife and I all expenses paid to go to Moscow for their 10th anniversary. It was the 10th anniversary of Russian Television America. And I learned that President Putin was very instrumental in the creation of this television. It was there when he got there, but he really got behind it. And so there was rumor he would show up at the occasion that night, and sure enough, it was confirmed, and he did. And so it was remarkable to me to be honored, because they brought all the people who are on Russian television up on the stage, and to be honored, and I'm sitting there, it was like being in the Twilight Zone. I mean, here I am, a Vietnam veteran. I've lived through the entire Cold War. I've looked at these people with fear my whole life, because I've been brainwashed to do so. And I get over there and I find out, guess what? They're just like we are. They really and truly are the people. When I traveled there, I left here at night and traveled and got there at night. I'm driving to the hotel and I'm looking outside. And Minnesota is a very festive Christmas state when it comes to putting out lights and all the paraphernalia that goes along with the celebration of Christmas. Minnesota looked like pikers compared to Moscow. My wife and I had never seen so many decorations honoring and enjoying the festive holiday as we did driving at night in Moscow. I actually thought for a moment they took me up. They did circles up there for 10 to 12 hours and then landed me back in Minneapolis, because you know what the next thing I saw over there was?
No.
McDonald's and Kentucky Fried Chicken. And I truly thought, am I still in Minneapolis? But then, of course, you know, it went on and we went to the thing and Putin was there. Putin got up and gave a speech that was outstanding, and I have to back him up on it. He said that they would never interfere with our opinions on the show. He would never interfere in any of our creativity of we the talent could bring to Russian Television America. And I have to tell you, I've been on there for 1 year now, and what he spoke was the truth, because they have never interfered one bit in anything I've talked about, any subject that I deemed to give my opinion on.
I know I've not been censored. So I mean, I know I've not been censored when I've come on your show, but that sounds so surreal that you take off in the middle of winter wonderland, you land back in the middle of winter wonderland, and you also talked about Putin coming over and talking to you. I want you to repeat that for folks, and then also talk about some of the other panels that you were part of, and your description of me, that Russia's going in the right direction, it looks like, and we're going in the wrong direction. So.
Oh, you want me to go? I thought we were going to break. No, I'll go
skip
right there.
It.
No. President Putin was sitting there, and after I was honored, when he got up to leave, he came up the aisle and he expressly came over to me, and we shook hands and looked eye to eye, and he quietly leaned into me and he just said very quietly, "Thank you, Governor," which I was astounded over. Because first of all, he gave me my title, which I rarely get anymore in the United States of America. You know, people don't refer to me as the governor anymore, but yet he did. And the big thing out of Putin was his speech to me. You know, the guy is a dynamic speaker. And then being around Russia, it appears to me that they are heading towards this newfound freedom that they've discovered since the communists have fallen, and they now refer to them as the communists. We were given a bus tour where we drove all over Moscow to go to RT, the studios, and it required about a 45-minute drive, and we had a person on board showing us all the buildings and this and that. I got to see the old building that the KGB operated out of, and then we actually went into the Kremlin, and it's remarkable to go into the Kremlin. The museum inside the Kremlin is unbelievable. And then the biggest thing I decided the last day I was going to be wild and woolly Jesse. So I wore my fringe jacket. I wore a do-rag. I had a pair of shades on, and I was looking like Jesse the Body. And I came walking, and there was a young couple, beautiful young couple, a boy and a girl. couldn't speak a word of English. But they came up to me so happy and so full of life, I couldn't believe it because they were astounded over my clothing, you know, of what I was wearing. And that's the feeling I got over there. When I left Moscow, it, to me it was, these people are no different than people in Minnesota. There is no difference. The only difference we have is how we're getting orchestrated into hating each other for 50 years for no frickin' reason.
Well, that's right. Longer than that, let me just say my point on this because it's a very important point. I've studied this in depth. Social engineers, British royalty, the British Empire, basically, but also Wall Street, wanted to bring down the czars, and they had their own corruption, their own problems. It was feudal Russia. But in 1917, they funded the Bolsheviks out of the United States and England on record to take it down, bring it down. It was a color revolution, just like you see happening in Kiev and Ukraine right now, or in Syria. Rebels were sent in after World War One, when Russia was weak at the end of it, who was our ally. We double-crossed them. I mean, this is our elites did. And we put the demons that are communist in there that killed tens of millions of people and then turned Russia into basically an enemy of free countries. And Russia did do some bad stuff, but it gave the United States the cover to do a lot of bad expansion in the name of stopping the domino theory. So that was the multi-leveled chess that the globalists were playing. Now Putin's kicked the oligarchs out, kicked the foreigners out. He's reversing the eugenics policies, reversing the communist programs, cutting taxes, and really following an Americana plan. The Russians love Levi's and what they see as Americana. They saw us as what they wanted to be. Solzhenitsyn saw that, but he saw that evil was here by the 90s. He left back and warned Russia, they're coming for you. And Putin went and met with him a lot and actually got woken up by Solzhenitsyn. They brought the Orthodox Church back, you name it. Russia is reforming because they've already hit rock bottom. We're now going into the greatest tyranny we've ever seen, bipartisan.
Yeah. And I agree with you. I over there, I see this budding blossom of freedom happening, of people getting their shackles off. And you can feel it. Here, the shackles are going on. We got one on one ankle right now, and they're grabbing for the second ankle right now.
Well said.
And I see us, we are going in the opposite directions, maybe to the same level. Maybe Russia will stop and will stop when they have everybody shackled down still. I don't know. I hope Russia keeps going in the direction that they're going. But we have to stop the direction we're going in. And to me, the way you stop it. Do you know, Alex, that right now, world opinion, if you ask anyone outside the United States, what country do you believe you'll most likely go to war with?
They say the
United States is number one.
Yes, very sad.
I think we should hang our head in shame over that. As a veteran, I do. I hang my head in shame. People think that's wonderful. They think that it's great that the rest of the world shakes in their boots, worried about whether the United States is going to attack them or not.
Let me bring this up because I want to be clear, though, and I agree with you totally. Globalists have hijacked our country. They've hijacked Europe. They are using our name to do it. It's our responsibility to stop it. Polls show Americans don't like this imperialism. We're paying for it on top of it, and we're trying to reform ourselves. The problem is the militarists control both major parties. Now, expanding on that, I don't know if you saw the last Republican debate, but Santorum said it's time to punch the Russians in the nose, give them a bloody nose. Then Chris Christie said, I want to start shooting down their aircraft. And Rand Paul looked at him and said, well, if you want World War III, vote for these maniacs.
Exactly. You know what gets me? Every one of these big mouths that state all that and talk all that robust crap have never served themselves. They have nobody in the military. They don't have a dog in the fight. But they're happy to send your kids off to die. You know, if one of the first things I'd do, Alex, if I became president, I would work to pass a law that anyone that votes to go to war, they must pre-designate a family member, be it a nephew, somebody. They must pre-designate a family member who, when they take that vote to go to war, that family member immediately starts military service.
Well, that sounds very draconian, but if you go back to the age of chivalry that really ended about 200 years ago or so in Europe and Japan, you name it, didn't end until just about 50 years ago, they wouldn't follow a leader.
I don't care about draconian. I care that they need a dog in the fight. I'm 64 years old now, Alex, and I've watched us go through Korea, Vietnam, and all the rest of this.
Well, Governor, let me just agree with you, because hear my whole point. It sounds draconian, but it's not, because in every culture, if the king didn't put his sons in the front lines or if he didn't fight, no one would follow him. It's a default. And so I want to go one further. All these politicians, I don't care how old they are, who they are, there needs to be a provision that there's combat units just for them, that they've got a command from the front line when they call for war. I think they should be in the middle of it, Governor.
Well, you're not going to get that. Settle for mine, mine, that they at least have to name a family member, be it a daughter, a son, or somebody has to begin military service at the point of the vote.
And it can't be behind a desk.
Because, Alex, I was asked one time by Jason Lewis, a right-wing talk show host here in Minnesota. I think he's running for Congress now. You know, but I was asked by him one time. He said it's a huge decision to make the decision to go to war. It's a difficult, difficult decision. And I looked at Lewis. I said, "No, look, Jason. I said it's an easy decision."
Stay there, Governor. He goes, "We got to go to break. Come back and tell us the story." Jesse Ventura, hot interview. All right, folks. Former Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura is our guest. If you'd like to talk to him, the toll-free number is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Now, we've still got free shipping going today. It was going to end Sunday or so, but it's been left up at InfoWarsStore.com. So if you want any of the great products, the Hillary for Prison t-shirt, the Molon Lave t-shirts, that special will run until tomorrow morning, but we are going to pull the free shipping. And I really just want to thank everybody that has bought products at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. When you buy the high-quality Mexican organic coffee from Chiapas, you're getting what I think some of the best coffee out there at a very low price and a free coffee cup, InfoWars coffee cup made in America. That's two bags of the coffee, and then you get a free coffee mug, a $9 value. When you buy the Survival Shield Nascent Iodine X2, you're not just getting the truest, purest iodine that we could ever find, the best that anybody out there has. I mean, we've done our research, that blocks the bad halogens like fluoride, helps clean out the thyroid. It's just amazing what it does for me. Talk about energy. Whoa. Try a bottle. You know you're supporting the broadcast. 20% off that. 33% off some of the package deals of some of the products. But regardless, you are funding InfoWars.com. You are funding the nightly news, this syndicated radio show. When you go get the Deep Cleanse Pack and get 33% off, when you get some of the other specials that are there, this is how we fund this operation. The Essentials Pack, 33% off. Super Male or Female Vitality, Silver Bullet, and Survival Shield Nascent Iodine X2. I know this. I've had colds before that antibiotics don't kick, and Silver Bullet for me personally did. Does that mean Silver Bullet's a total Silver Bullet? No. But the properties of 30 parts per million colloidal silver have been known for a long time. That's why old timers would put, you know, silver dollars in their milk jugs in their root cellar to keep it, you know, fresh longer. Check it out for yourself, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. But again, I want to thank all of you that are supporters and that do buy the products, because shopping with the good guys is what makes all this possible. Voting with your dollars separately. We've run a special for 15 years since I started my subscription site for my films, live events, other documentary films, ebooks, you name it. But for now, 4 years, we've had the InfoWars Nightly News. It's all archived there, HD, and you pay it forward. When you get a $5.95 a month membership, it helps fund us then putting out most of what we do for free on YouTube and other platforms. But we've got to have the money to produce it. People are like, well, then why should I pay for it if it's free to others? That's the whole point. And a lot of folks get that. Some don't. You get first use, HD. A lot of it's exclusive, like the commercial-free podcast, special events. There is exclusive stuff there. But 90% of it is given away the next day to everybody. That's the whole point in the info war. Billionaire globalists give all this money to, you know, overthrow our freedoms, come after our guns, like Bloomberg. You have to then spend $5.95 a month to help fund this truly independent libertarian operation. So I want to salute those of you that have and encourage those of you that haven't to go sign up today. It takes about 60 seconds with a credit card or PayPal or other systems to sign up. Then you get a username and passcode. Now, the username, folks, will let 20 people sign up. 20 people sign up or sign in for free. 20 people can go log in when you sign up once simultaneously for $5.95 a month. Now, that's the normal yearly membership. It's half off, ladies and gentlemen, 6 months free. We're only running it this December into early January. We've always offered 5 months free. We're doing 6 months free because bandwidth prices have gone down. We're able to do this more affordably. That's how each membership can be used by 20 people. This is so exciting. So please share your membership with friends and family and sign up for a year and get 6 months free. When I say half off, when you normally sign up for a year, you get 2 months free. So it's $54.95 normally. Right now it's $36.50 off. That's because you're signing up for a year and getting 6 months free. It would be like, you know, 70-something bucks, but with the 2 months free, it's 54, and then with the 6 months free, it's 36. So that's how that works out. $36, sign up for a year. 20 people can watch for an entire year and help fund the operation and download it and keep copies on your computer, burn it to disk, give it to friends. That's how we reach people, is you taking action. So don't thank me for all the success of InfoWars. We want to thank you. And our job is supporting other independent media. Other media that isn't controlled and tells it like it is. That's why I promote what Jesse Ventura does. It's why he has me on his show. It's why I promote Ron Paul's channel. It's why the folks that put him on cable in Houston have put me on there. We all just work together. Drudge promotes us. We promote Drudge. WorldNet Daily promotes us. We promote WorldNet Daily. This is what it's all about, is coming together to promote basic liberty and freedom in this country. Now, going back to the former Minnesota governor, Jesse Ventura, whose own TV show got censored. That's Inside Baseball, but I wish he'd tell that story sometime. It's pretty revealing. He just got back from Russia. Amazing talks with CIA former people at panels, you name it. Governor, let's get into more of what you witnessed in Russia. Then I want to shift gears into Vladimir Putin and Donald Trump being buddies. You now know Vladimir Putin, and of course you're friends with Donald Trump. That's quite a story right there as well.
I guess so. Well, the big thing was they also had panel discussions over there with moderators and things like that. You could sit in on them. And the one I found very interesting, there were two former lifetime CIA people who are now retired, one a whistleblower. And the real thing, we were dealing with communication. So that's what they kind of centered everything about, because it's television. And they talked about how all of this surveillance that they're putting the United States people under, violating our Fourth Amendment rights, and they've got us all now under surveillance. Clearly, both guys said it doesn't work and won't work. And they said the clear example is what just took place in Southern California. If the surveillance worked, these people would have been apprehended before they did what they did. So clearly, it's a snow job. They can't protect you with this surveillance. Both men were very clear on that you're not going to be protected any better by putting everyone under surveillance, all your emails, all your telephone calls, and basically they told us that they all are. Now, whether or not they get the places, but basically they said the entire United States is under surveillance right now.
Well, Drake has been on, William Binney's been on, the former head of technical for the NSA, and they said it's even worse than what you're saying. You're absolutely right. They are taking in so much data that then any real data gets lost like a needle in a haystack.
Exactly. That's what these two guys said. They said they may get the data, but there's so much of it because they're not targeting. They're just doing this blanket coverage of putting every person's email under surveillance that they can't possibly find, you know, the bad ones slip by. You know, they may find a few, but there's going to be some that slip by.
Well, let's go further. It actually came out in the Associated Press and Reuters that the FBI was investigating the mosque and these two reported shooters, but was ordered by Obama administration and a civil rights task force to stop it 2 years ago. So it's even beyond that. It's even worse than that. But you're right. They're using the threat of terror to take our liberties and to launch all these new wars. Remember, Saudi Arabia supposedly was involved in the attacks, which we now know with the 28 pages. So we attack Iraq. And Governor, do you feel vindicated? Because when you 4 years ago did your big 9/11 special and interviewed all those experts, you got demonized nationally for bare minimum saying Saudi Arabia was involved and our government stood down. We know it's worse than that. And you looked at Building 7 on national TV, never before done. I mean, that was truly groundbreaking material. And now that stuff's all been verified. It's all come out.
Well, I feel personally vindicated. I'm not sure if the public has taken the stigma off me yet, because the public still loves to keep the blinds in front of their eyes for whatever reason. They like the comfort zone. They don't want to know the truth. And so I personally feel vindicated. You know, if they'd release these 28 pages that show a direct monetary from the hijackers to Saudi Arabia, which Senator Graham and Congressman Cook assured me that's what's in it. They've read it. And if that be the case, then that does change 9/11 completely. And then it begs the question, why in hell did we invade Iraq? You know, I don't know. Did you ever see that special Vince Bugliosi did about prosecuting George Bush for murder? If you haven't, watch it.
I've seen it. We had Bugliosi on to promote it. It's very powerful.
Oh, I watched it the other day and was fuming out my ears.
But see, I'm bipartisan, just like you are. I wonder if Bugliosi is going to expose Obama for all the wars he's been involved in.
Unfortunately, died.
That's right. That's right.
Vince passed away a year ago.
I knew that. I forget when people have died. The older you get, it's like you start talking about somebody and you go, oh, wait a minute, they're dead.
Yeah, unfortunately, Vince went to the other side of, about a year ago. And I'll truly miss him, because he and I differed greatly on the killing of Kennedy, but we still were able to remain good friends.
Boy, he sure was wrong about that.
Very much.
I mean, Kennedy is open and shut. It's ridiculous.
I don't know. I don't know why. And, you know, I'm reading a book right now, Alex, that's phenomenal. Talbot wrote it. It's on Alan Dulles.
Oh, yeah.
Unbelievable. I encourage people, get this book. It will show you there's even tie-ins from Alan Dulles to Donald Rumsfeld.
I knew that. Through L.L. Lemnitzer. Yeah, Rumsfeld first worked for L.L. Lemnitzer, who Eisenhower fired when he came up with the Northwoods plan.
Well, anyway, this book by Talbot's phenomenal. It deals totally with Alan Dulles from when he took over the CIA all the way through till he died. I'm not even finished. I'm just up to the Kennedy killing right now. But it's an unbelievable book that I encourage people, if you got the guts, read it, to read the truth about how they this guy murdered people throughout the world. So how easy would it be for him to just turn around and murder our president? He murdered other presidents.
Well, let me just say, in Texas, in Austin, and in Dallas, when you get around rich people and famous people and folks involved in these administrations, I have actually been on airplanes and at parties where people sit around shooting their mouth off about killing that son of a bitch, JFK. I mean, it's not hidden around here. And that's why LBJ, in front of his mistress, who I interviewed, many other people, just walked around bragging about it. I mean, it wasn't even debated. I mean, my grandmother dated one of LBJ's hitmen before she got married. I'm sorry, go ahead.
It became part of the world then, because they were being so successful throughout the rest of the world, overthrowing if any country elected a president who was at all leftist or at all for the people and not for big industry or corporations, the United States would go in there and overthrow their governments. It's horrible when you read about it.
I absolutely agree with what you're saying. Now, again, let's drill in here to this Donald Trump situation.
Okay.
And the situation that ties into Putin and Hillary, because I guess you know all three of these people, but I guess Trump the best. Hillary's come out and said that Putin has journalists killed, and I'm sure Putin isn't perfect, but I've never seen the cut and dry evidence of it. And now Donald Trump has fired back defending Putin. I mean, imagine if Trump did get in, and then we didn't have to have a new Cold War with Russia. Imagine actually trying to have peace. I think that's what really puts Donald Trump in danger. But let's go to this clip.
Final question about Vladimir Putin. When you were pressed about his killing of journalists, you said, I think our country does plenty of killing, too. What were you thinking about? Killing sanctioned by the U.S. government is like killing journalists.
Well, I think, number one, I think Hillary, when she was Secretary of State, made some horrible, horrible decisions, and thousands and even hundreds of thousands of people have been killed. You look at what went on in Libya. You look at so many bad decisions that she made. She's incompetent, as far as I'm concerned.
That's
you
not
look at
killing
her rage,
by the United
incompetent.
States government, though.
As far
that's
as the reporters
the
are concerned, as far as the reporters are concerned, obviously, I don't want that to happen. I think it's horrible. But in all fairness to Putin, you're saying he killed people. I haven't seen that. I don't know that he has.
Kidding.
Have you been able to prove that? Do you know the names of the reporters that he's killed? Because, you know, you've been hearing this, but I haven't seen the name. Now, I think it would be despicable if that took place, but I haven't seen any evidence that he killed anybody in terms of reporters.
Here's what Mitt Romney tweeted about that. He said there's an important distinction here. Thug Putin kills journalists and opponents. Our presidents kill terrorists and enemy combatants.
All right, let's stop right there. Okay, there's no proof, no convictions.
Really, we just kill terrorists and enemy combatants and doctors, right?
But they don't have any proof. It's like they say that I say that there's WASP under the...
Alex, I'm just adding, they forgot to put in doctors.
I agree.
Remember when we attacked doctors without borders?
Well, they also attacked press stations. They
murdered 40 of them.
They blew up the Belgrade national TV station, killing a bunch of people in Serbia.
Yeah. So, you know, people need to understand the United States of America isn't clean on this. We've been doing dastardly things throughout the world my entire life.
Governor, I totally agree with you, but here's my angle. They claim you got pulled over drunk in L.A. at the airport when you weren't in L.A. and weren't drunk and there was no police record. They claim that you made fun of dead Navy SEALs with no proof. You went in court. You can't get your name back in some areas. It's the same thing with me. They say every day things I never said, and now they say it about Putin. Where is the proof? Their proof is Mitt Romney says so? I mean, again, that's crazy. Go ahead.
Oh, I agree totally. You know, a guy with magic underwear, I'm going to believe him. Anyway, I shouldn't have said that, I guess, but I had to throw a little comedic back at it. But, you know, that's the whole thing. Who do you believe? Because we get fed so much propaganda in this country. About 2 years ago, Vladimir Putin did a major speech that was carried throughout the world, yet no one in the United States carried this speech. Why? Why? Why aren't we allowed to hear what the guy has to say?
That's like Nazi Germany wouldn't let foreign media in. That's a
exactly.
Real sign of totalitarianism. The old Russia wouldn't
Alex,
let
Alex, we're behaving like Germany. Look at our cops out on the street today. They don't look like police officers. They look like Nazi stormtroopers.
And that has been the federal government pushing that whole agenda.
Whatever's pushing it, we need to look in the mirror. Because if you read about 1930s Germany, you compare to what's going on here today, it's identical, people. Wake up.
Did you see a lot of police in Moscow?
You see a few, sure. Yeah, I mean, the Kremlin's, you know, you got to go through security to get into the Kremlin.
How were they dressed?
Huh?
How were the Russian police dressed?
They were dressed more, like Cossacks. Well, I don't know. They're dressed more joyously. They wear, like, those big coats and big hats, you know?
Hey.
I don't know how to describe. They're dressed like the stereotype you see in the movies.
I know. We need to get you in one of those outfits, Jesse. You'd look pretty imposing.
I'm Slovak. That's close.
No, I know. That's exactly what I'm saying. You'd be scary looking in one of those outfits. Stay right there. We'll be right back with Jesse Ventura and your phone calls, I promise. The thing I like about... And by the way, Jesse's with us in other segments. We can get to all your calls. The thing I like about the fact that we're able to broadcast 3-4 hours a day is we can really get into some long-form ideas and really break some things down. And that's why I like Donald Trump. For all of his problems, nobody's perfect. You know, he says, hey, we shouldn't be bombing all these countries. We should come home and rebuild America. Well, that's what Jesse Ventura says. And then they criticize Trump because that's not a Republican talking point. Well, it's just a common sense talking point. We're going bankrupt. We have to rebuild this country. I'm now stealing Ventura's thunder, but he was preaching to me during the break that was important to do, and I totally agree with him. I mean, what's the military-industrial complex going to do if they fully bankrupt this country, Governor?
Well, that's just it. We've spent over $1.7 trillion in the war on terror over there, and we've accomplished nothing.
I think it's more than that.
I say you bring the troops home, use them to secure your borders, and take this defense money and start rebuilding America. Do people in this country realize every time we drop a bomb, that could be a new bridge, and that could be jobs to people building that bridge? It's time to come home, fix up our country, take care of our backyard.
And that is not a Democrat talking point.
Handle their own problems.
And that's not a Democratic talking point. Whenever Trump says that, they accuse him of being a Democrat. You're not a Democrat, Jesse. That's just common sense.
Hell no, I'm not either. I'm your independent who's always been independent. I'm a free thinker, but I know the difference between right and wrong.
Absolutely. Let's go to Nick in Michigan. He's a Marine vet. You're on the air. Go ahead, Nick.
Governor Ventura, it's an absolute honor to talk to you. This is a question for really both you guys. I'm a Marine veteran. My oldest brother is still active duty. I have a younger brother who also served. My dad served. And now my youngest brother, who has a college education, he's looking to enlist in the Marine Corps right now. And me and my dad and my one brother are trying to talk him out of going in the Marine Corps. What would you say to somebody in that situation who has a college degree?
I would say don't do it because the vaccines alone is a death sentence. I mean, it hurts them bad. But, Governor, what's your view on this? Thank you, Nick.
My view is simple. I come from a similar family. Everyone in both my mother and father were World War II vets, and everyone in my family served. That's an individual thing and a decision someone has to make, and that's their decision to make. What I say to young people is this. Always remember, if you take that step and you raise and take an oath, remember in that oath, you're taking an oath to protect the Constitution and the Bill of Rights of this country against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and never forget
that
you took an oath to do that.
That's right. Let's go to Wild in Wisconsin. Another call from Wisconsin. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Jonesy, Mr. Governor, with the upper and lower arcana at hand with the globalists, Trump has to seal the deal for the presidency before the book of tricks gets fully implemented. Trump needs to have a dog in the fight and make a masterpiece of a deal with the American people and the establishment. If he doesn't, make America great again, then he should take his name off the building.
Sure. What's your question for Governor Ventura? Because we have limited time.
Sure. I want to know if Mr. Ventura believes Trump to be legitimate or part of the CEO elite class.
That's a really great question, Jesse.
Well, I think Trump is his own man in a lot of ways. I don't know for certain. Don't take it to the bank. But he was involved in the independent movement. He actually came to a fundraiser in Minnesota way back in the 90s when I ran as an independent for governor. And Donald's always kind of rattled his sword about running. I never believed he actually would. And then this year and I said, I don't believe it. I think Donald does it for the publicity. He's a brilliant man. This year he actually has done it. And this year he looks like he's going to see it through till the end. And, you know, the guy can do what he wants. He's got enough money to where he can't be stopped on the monetary end.
So there you go. Jesse Ventura says he's his own man. I agree with that. I've now had some behind-the-scenes stuff, and Tara's had a lot of it, and Trump's for real. Does that mean he's perfect? Absolutely not. We'll be back in 70 seconds. Final segment with Ventura. More calls. The story's up on Infowars.com. MSNBC says white men with guns, bigger threat than radical Islam. White men. Just incredible race baiting. Jesse Ventura is with us. You can, of course, go to Aura TV and find his Off the Grid show. Very popular. Be sure and spread the word about that. It's also on RT. And we're taking phone calls right now. And Jesse, you've also updated your book. Tell folks about that, your latest book.
Well, we did updated American Conspiracies, where we added four new conspiracies to it, Alex. It seems that every year you'll get a new one these days because the government will do something or something will rise up that you realize is a major cover-up. And, you know, we did a thing on POWs, which was close to me because you're led to believe when you join the military and you're told that if you ever get captured, our government will do anything and everything to get you returned home. Well, it's simply not true. If you become a political liability, kiss your butt goodbye. They could care less about you.
Well, look at Pat Tillman. He didn't go along with the narrative. They killed him dead in a hammer. Joe in Connecticut, you're on the air with Jesse Ventura. Go ahead.
Hi, Governor. This is Joe from Connecticut. I don't know if this has been asked of you, but I want to ask you, if Donald Trump gets the nomination, which I believe he's going to, and I sure hope he is, would you consider being his running mate? Because I think the two of you would be a fantastic combination.
Joe, thank you. Your radio's on. I'm going to let you go. Go ahead, Jesse.
Well, first of all, remember, this is the Republican Party. Jesse Ventura is hardly a Republican. They know me. I'm like Che Guevara to them. I'm the revolutionary. I'm the independent. I belong to neither party.
So you don't think that bird will fly?
I said it jokingly. I told Roger Stone, I said, if Donald truly wants to tick off the Republicans, he should pick me as his running mate, the ultimate independent, to bring that independent vote along. It would be a smart move on Trump's part to do that. But I doubt it would ever happen. And besides, I still have to make the decision on whether I make a libertarian move the end of May.
And that was my next question. Look, I'm not normally for third party runs if you're going to try to choose somebody from one of the two parties. And normally, I mean, I didn't support McCain or Obama because of that. I see your view about them being two gangs. But Trump clearly is trying to take over the Republican Party. If they steal the delegates in a broker convention, which Jeb Bush says they're planning to do, Jeb's got 5% of the vote, but he gets the nomination. You've got to have Trump go. The only place you could get ballot access would be with the Libertarians. And so if you take that slot, then he can't take it. But his ace in the hole is leaving and taking over the Libertarian nomination.
Yeah, but the problem is, Alex, the Libertarians nominate the end of May. The Republicans won't even decide till July.
No, I understand
so
that.
Trump will stay with the Republicans till it's too late. And then he can't come back to the Libertarians. He's got to ride the horse to the convention, doesn't he?
Yes, and that's the problem.
And that's the problem. Once he goes to the convention, if they steal it from him, he has nowhere to go because the Libertarians will have already nominated in May.
Are you concerned that they may be planning, like they've done before, to try to steal the nomination from him?
I don't know. I'm always concerned about that. You know, I don't trust either one of these two political parties. To me, they're a gang of thieves because they operate under the concept of bribery. All they do is, their job is to go out and take bribes and pass it on, and you bribe them and you get what you want. And the people of America, hell, we're third or fourth on their list, you know. Number one is their parties. Number two is the corporations that finance them and the big money. We might be third. We might even be as low as fourth.
Well, folks,
their personal gain would be third. What can I achieve? What level can I help myself out personally instead of being in public service? So we, the people of America, probably align ourselves up as the fourth choice with these two political parties.
That's right. Well, folks, you can find Aura TV and Off the Grid, Jesse Ventura. Governor, I don't want to say I'm, you know, glad you didn't go to Mexico this Christmas, but I'm glad you're here so you come on the show. Look forward to speaking to you more as the campaign unfolds, and who knows, maybe see you throw your hat in the ring.
Well, I'm not throwing it out yet. I'm sitting back in the weeds and watching, Alex, and I want to see what comes through the wash. I got to see the pikers get out. Oh, one last funny thing.
Hold on. You got to stay there. The brake's firing. Got to come right back. Stay there. All right, Jesse Ventura with us into the third hour today. It's such an interesting interview that he's been hanging around with us. He's about to leave. And I know we got loaded phone lines, but I need to get into some more world news. I need to get into some really important news with the economy, some really important news when it comes to geoengineering. In fact, Jesse Ventura wanted to tell one more funny Chris Christie story, but it's so intriguing, you know, all the inside baseball and things that the governor knows with the people he sees all over the country. I look forward to having him back sometime just to tell some of his more interesting stories. Not just from Hollywood, but politics, and as a governor, as a mayor, you name it. A lot of the stories I know, but I'm not allowed to tell them because I was there, and it's all private. And I get holding your cards close to the vest, but, man, I wish people knew about Homeland Security and the TV show and the rest of it. I think people don't get how much trouble you've got to go through to get on the air and talk about these topics. And one of those, Governor, and then we'll get into your Chris Christie story, I'm glad that you were able to stay longer. I'm going to cover this at the bottom of the hour, folks. Smithsonian came out Saturday, the Associated Press on Sunday, and a whole bunch of other articles admitting that, the jet exhaust is darkening the atmosphere and is toxic, and they don't know what's happening, even though we have thousands of documents admitting it's part of a program since the 90s. where, of course, the pilots don't know, but it's added to the jet fuel. Then there's spray planes as well. You exposed that yet again the first time on national television and got made fun of, got ridiculed. I have friends who like the show and believe in conspiracies, but they think this is kooky, even though it's admitted. So what do you make of that announcement? Here's the Smithsonian.com. Airplane contrails may be creating accidental geoengineering. Well, nothing accidental about it, Jesse.
Well, there probably is nothing accidental about anything. The story I'll tell is this. They have McDonald's over in Moscow, and Putin is so opposed to the GMOs, they won't allow them in Moscow, genetic modified food. And so the McDonald's there has to use all Russian ingredients. And people told me, now I didn't try it, but people told me McDonald's hamburgers in Moscow are way better than the hamburgers in the United States.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They have standards. In fact, there's been articles on this, Governor. You can look it up. So what you're telling us is just proven by other, you know, food critics. In Japan, in Russia, and other countries, they have rules that you've got to use domestic food as part of the franchise, and you can get a McDonald's burger like they had 35 years ago that is actually good. The fried chicken doesn't have all the GMO, all the chemicals, all the antibiotics. Absolutely. It's well known that the food's better over there because they won't allow additives. In fact, did you hear Putin came out and said he wants to make Russia the first world exporter of organic food?
No, I didn't, but it doesn't surprise me. After hearing him speak that night, it wouldn't surprise me at all. Let me finish with this, Alex. You know, Chris Christie seems to be this major hawk. He wants to blow everybody out of the air and do all that. Chris Christie couldn't even serve in the military, Alex. When you go into boot camp, they require that you at least have to be able to do one sit-up and one push-up.
You're kidding. He couldn't do one push-up or one sit-up.
You think he could?
No, I bet he couldn't.
That's what I mean. Here's a guy telling all the kids to go to war, and he in his whole life could never even make it into the military because he's so out of shape.
What is it about neocons, hawks, that the ones that shoot their mouths off about bloody noses and kill the Russians are the ones that never served? I mean, I was never in the military, but I studied enough history to know that you just don't nonchalantly start wars. But even in the past, people that were warrior presidents or kings weren't respected for shooting their mouths off about we're going to crush the enemy because that was seen as bad luck. I mean, as a Navy SEAL, I mean, I know a lot of Special Forces guys. They'll never brag about how tough they are. They'll never brag about killing people. Isn't that looked down upon by real warriors?
Yeah, absolutely. Now, that's a little different today because today they seem to like to come home and write books about it. But in my day, you didn't discuss that. We used to operate under the simple premise it's the Las Vegas thing. What happens on deployment stays on deployment.
Well,
it's that simple.
You're absolutely
right. My father had 6 bronze battle stars in World War II. I didn't even know it till he died, and I read it on his DD-214, his discharge papers.
Yeah, my dad's dad was in the Army Air Corps as a pilot, and he always said, oh, I got heat stroke, hurt my eyes, not wearing sunglasses, only flew a few missions, and then when he died, they got into all his stuff, and he'd done his missions, and then, you know, after you did your Catch-22, then, you know, he was put into just Army management and stuff in the invasion of Italy, but he never told the family any of it. No one ever knew any of it.
No, that's the way it was done. That was, see, my father, interesting for me, I came out of the 50s and my mother did all the driving. And I could never figure out why, because this was the Leave It to Beaver era. Dads drove, moms didn't. In my family, my mom drove. So I asked my dad one day, I said, Dad, how come you don't drive? And he told me, he said, oh, I don't trust myself. And I thought, that's legitimate. If you don't trust yourself, you shouldn't drive. Well, when my dad passed away, my mom told me the real reason, post-traumatic stress. He was in the 699th anti-tank division under Patton, and apparently he drove these anti-tank things over so many dead bodies that he could never get behind the wheel of a car again.
Yeah, I always tried to get these
to work. My dad walked to work every morning, 2 miles, walked to work, never drove a car.
And people like Chris Christie thinks war is sexy.
Yeah, they think that's our whole culture today, Alex. We're making war look like it's a wonderful thing. It is not wonderful, people. It's man at his lowest level. It's the worst man can possibly be, is war. And yet we're turning in. I mean, I get embarrassed when I watch these ads on TV with Arnold in the war game. Schwarzenegger?
Yeah, I don't follow him. Tell me about it.
No, it's on. He's doing some sort of war video game now that are also popular, and they got him dressed up in a uniform. And with the way he talks, it sounds and looks like the Nazis.
I tell you,
you know, and it's all glorified. You look at all these games they put out to the kids. It all glorifies war as some wonderful, wonderful thing. And the final thing, and I'll stop bitching. When I'm so anti now, when I learned that our Department of Defense was paying professional sports to honor the veterans, that was the last straw for me, Alex. I will not go live to another pro sports event in my life, I don't believe.
Well, I'm looking at this video of Schwarzenegger taking over an army war room, and it is totally Nazi. All the iconography, the way he's operating, the way he's saying how great war is. And our public thinks war now is a video game.
Arnold, I'm not mad at him, but that's the culture of America today.
Well, Arnold has become a caricature of a caricature, and I tell you, with all these chicken hawks and people out there pushing war, it is certainly a scary thing. I don't think you're bitching. I think you're bringing up concerns that most Americans and others really, really have. Jesse Ventura, thank you so much for the time today.
Thank you, Alex. Always a pleasure, and maybe we'll do it again before I head south.
Please, please come back on, and
all right. Thanks
for the time. Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
All right, there he goes. Now, I talked to Ventura during a break, and I said, are you serious about building a wall now and bringing our military home? And he goes, no, I'm not joking. Because I said, look, I don't want to get into the immigration thing with you again. Whole crew heard it, and I'm not saying something out of school. He said he'd say it again on air, but we forgot to get into it again because I was talking to him during a break like 30 minutes ago. I said, hey, repeat everything you just said on air. And he goes, okay, I will, and then we never got to it. But I was like, listen, I don't want to get into the immigration fight because on your side they say we all want to throw women and children out and we're not loving, and on our side we're saying we just can't pay for everything free, let the Democrats advertise a bunch of anti-gunners to come in. Because that's what's happening. I mean, they brag, it's game over. So he's like, no, I'm being serious. I'm saying with all the security stuff and the rest of it, I'd rather not be an empire. Bring back the military, put it on our border, stop all immigration. Actually sounds pretty good for a while, doesn't it? I mean, would you end all this garbage? Do you think countries would really attack us? We've got submarines and nukes and all this stuff. We just left the world alone? Nobody messes with Switzerland. They don't even have nuclear weapons. They're neutral. Oh, the jihadis will attack us because criminal federal elements are funding the jihadis and letting them come in to attack us because they've suspended common sense and logic to where when we get attacked, the politicians who brought them in don't get in trouble. And then they get to take our freedoms, have $100 billion surveillance budgets every year. $100 billion is spent on these intelligence agencies and surveillance every year. $100 billion.
Man, game over, man. It's game over.
And the special interests want to suck this country dry. When the country collapses down the road, it'll be done slowly probably, but as it collapses, it's by design. They're going to the world government model now. They don't want any country that's sovereign, any country that's strong.
Okay, so 2 years ago, I found myself on the couch, completely out of shape, overweight, I had no muscle tone, and I just felt horrible. And I knew I needed to make a change, and I needed to start going to the gym and working out. And I did that. I would force myself to go to the gym, and it just really wasn't going very well. that's when my buddy Alex told me to try the Super Male Vitality. And that's what changed everything for me.
Shane Steiner's involvement with InfoWarsLife.com truly happened in an organic way. I went to high school with Shane, his brother, knew his parents well. And he was visiting the office once, hadn't been to the office in years, and said, wow, I notice you're making and selling supplements. Do these really work? Because I've tried a lot of supplements as a workout enthusiast, and I really think most of them are hype. And I said, here, take some home, try it. Well, a few weeks later, he came in blown away and said, I want to buy 3 boxes of this stuff to give my friends and family. It's simply amazing. He said, why does it work so well? And I said, listen, go to InfoWarsLife.com, watch the informational videos with Dr. Group and others. They understand how it all works. I know that it works for me. That's all I understand. The science, the facts, the research, people's testimonials, they're all on InfoWarsLife.com. You can check it out for yourself.
I wanted to go to the gym. I wanted to push myself and work out harder. And that led to me being able to come out and do stuff like the barefooting and the surfing and stuff like that, which what I would have never done. I never would have done that 2 years ago.
Shane has said over and over again, more than just libido and energy, it made him want to get into the gym more. It made him want to get in better shape. And believe me, the Steiners have amazing genetics. His brother is a world champion steer wrestler. His dad, Bobby Steiner, is a famous world champion bull rider. They've got natural genetics. But when you added this to the mix, in Shane's own words, it took him to the next level. Shane noticed the mental clarity. Bobby was able to work out longer and gain muscle mass. He's already completely shredded. I gotta admit, for me, the biggest effect has been libido. Now, I've never claimed to have a body like some beach model, but back when I was 20, 22 years old and worked out every day, I looked great. But over the years, and being married, having 3 kids, and working 18 hours a day, I gained basically 100 pounds. And it's been a long process losing that weight in the last 4 years. But if you look at the photos and the videos of what I looked like 4 or 5 years ago versus today, the results are dramatic. I'd already cleaned up my diet, I was working out hard, but I'd only lost about 20 pounds. It was adding the other key ingredients from InfoWarsLife.com that helped me personally go to the next level and shed another 35 pounds.
This has actually made me feel so good that here lately, about a year ago, I started training jiu-jitsu, and that kind of led to doing some boxing and kickboxing. I mean, it's amazing that 2 years ago, I was on the couch and couldn't even tie my shoes, and now I'm training with MMA fighters and just doing stuff that I never thought that I would be doing ever again. So Super Male Vitality has allowed me to do some amazing things. And if it has those kind of effects for me, I know that it will do great things for you. So just try Super Male Vitality. I promise you, you'll love it.
And finally, let's look at Anthony Gucciardi, InfoWars.com reporter. He also works with Dr. Group and others, helping develop the newest, most cutting edge, high quality supplements. Let's take a look at what happened when he tried to barefoot ski for the first time with the Steiners. And remember, we're not making fun of him. He had the will to get in the arena, and he's lost more than 10 pounds in the last few years of fat and gained more than 10 pounds of muscle. And Anthony chalks it up to Super Male Vitality as well. Bottom line, folks, you want to discover the power of Super Male Vitality and Super Female Vitality for yourself by visiting InfoWarsLife.com today or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. Whoa.